Ìjọba.
Understanding your position in the kingdom.
Mímọ ipò rẹ nínú ìjọba.
Shall we pray, Father, in the name of Jesus?
Amen.
We thank you because your word is yea and amen. Your word is very important. When you want to walk, you speak words. We are praying that we speak your words to our lives and make your word to do wonders in our lives.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Understanding your position in the kingdom. Three or four weeks ago, I told you the structure of the kingdom of God. That in the kingdom of God, there is the king. The king is the Almighty God. The Almighty God. The creator of all the earth. He is the God that made you and I. He made everything in the universe.
He
is the king. The Bible calls him the King of Kings. The Lord of Lords. The one that is greater than the greatest. The higher than the highest.
The
God that was not created. He created all things. The existence of himself.
He
is the ancient of days.
He
is the one and only God. Besides him, there is no other God.
He
is the all powerful God.
He
is the one knowing God.
He
is the God of miracles.
He
is your God.
He is
my God.
He
is the king of that kingdom. Now in the kingdom, there is the domain or the territory. And the territory of God's kingdom is the whole universe. It's not Ogbaye, Ogbo, universe is different from Aye. Because the universe has so many worlds inside it. And so, God's territory encompasses every area of life. It encompasses not only the plant life and the animal life, it goes beyond living and non-living things. And I also told you that in the kingdom there are 6 things. The citizens are those who have given their lives to Jesus. Those who have given their lives to Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. They are the citizens of the kingdom. But if you are not giving your life to Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you are not a citizen. You don't belong to that kingdom. And that is what some people are preaching, especially the Jehovah's Witness. They are trying to preach the kingdom of God, and people should repent of their sins and become a member of that kingdom, become a citizen of that kingdom. You need to be a citizen. Because citizens have rights and privileges. That other people do not have. When we talk about citizenship, we talk about rights. When we talk about citizenship, we talk about privileges. So as a citizen of the kingdom of heaven, you have some rights. Also in the kingdom of heaven we have the army. The army is different from the citizen. You have to understand that the army have more, they do not have as much rights as the citizen. The citizens have more rights than the army.
ọmọ olùgbé ìlú wọ́n ní ẹ̀tọ́ ju jamujamu lọ.
In the kingdom of heaven, the angels are the army of God.
Àwọn angẹ́lì àwọn jamujamu.
You see, when in a civilized world,
ní àwọn ìlú tí o tún ti là.
If you go to somebody's house,
tó bá lọ sí ẹ̀rù kan.
And you are trying to cheat that person.
So I don't know you not there.
And the person can lay down on the telephone.
Yeah,
you know I have to be
on one day.
They will phone the army straight.
So
when we talk about the army, we talk about police, air force, navy, army, inland army together. Custom, everything is what we refer to as the army.
Àwọn òkè wọn dámúdámú ojú omi àti torí ilẹ̀ gbogbo wọn láti kó wa pàdé pẹ̀lú.
So when the citizen falls, the army has said, I am in trouble. I'm in house eight, row 213, okay, you know, come and help me within 5 minutes. If I within 2 minutes, the army will be there.
Tí onílẹ̀ bá ti wá pé tó gbé fóònù rẹ̀ tó pe army pé ẹ̀dọ̀ ọmọ wa ní ojúlé kejì àdúgbò ìkẹta ní òkè ìdùnnú. Kéèké tó bá ń gbọ́ láàrin ìtọ́jú lójú wọn ti dé.
In fact, I'm told that in civilized country like America and Britain, if you beat your child.
Wọ́n sọ wá pé ní àwọn ìlú bíi Britain àti America tó bá na ọmọ rẹ.
And you beat that child in a way you should not beat that child.
Tó bá nà ní ọ̀nà tí kò yẹ kó o nà.
And that's why I get hold of the telephone and say hello.
Tí àwọn náà wá pé ẹ̀rọ
ààrẹ ìgbọ́jẹ̀ náà.
Mo wà ní
búlọ́ọ̀kì ẹ̀rọ. Oròtú bá ń lo ètò náà.
Ní àná àdúgbò tí
wọ́n bá wà almost to a state of coma.
Àbá mi ti nà mí mo ti fẹ́ dákú.
I am told that in those civilized countries, the police will rush in.
Wọ́n sọ pé ní àwọn ìlú wọ̀nyí ọlọ́pàá ó sá wá ní.
And the daddy will be arrested.
Àá sì dùn bàbá.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The citizens have so much privilege that the army has summons to the citizens.
Àwọn olùgbé wọ́n ní àwọn àpárí dé bí pé àwọn jamujamu máa wọ́n tẹ̀ ránṣẹ́.
That is why when you want to join the army in a civilized nation, what you give up as an army is your right. You give up your citizenship.
O ti òfin lélẹ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ bí jamujamu ní àwọn ẹ̀tọ́ rẹ gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọmọ onílùú.
So as an army of that nation, they don't have as much. The reason is that they cannot have as much freedom as we in this area. Because I can decide to go to Lagos today and stay in Lagos for the next 1 year. A soldier can never think of doing that. If he goes to Lagos today, as for not come back by tomorrow.
So that's the whole story to tell us.
Except he gets a pass.
And he said, I go to Charlie.
Then he can stay there for as long as the pass are missing.
So that's the whole story to tell us.
Now I am saying all these things is that I want you to understand your position. You are not an army. In the kingdom of God, you are a citizen. Somebody who have rights. You have rights. You have privileges. And these privileges are yours to enjoy. I want you to understand
it.
Amen.
Amen.
Because I'm talking about the kingdom, I'm not talking about this natural army, I'm talking the kingdom now. There is an army that guides us. They are called the angels. The angels are looking at us. If you look at the Bible, it's everywhere in the Bible. The Bible says, He shall give His angels charge. That is in Psalm 21.
Looking
at us.
I'm
not in the king. kingdom will also have the ambassador. The ambassadors are the representative of heaven on earth. The ambassadors are the servants and ministers of the Most High God. The ambassadors are the people that have a word for their country. If your life is infringed in that nation, you can talk to your ambassador. Your ambassador can stand for you and say, ladies and gentlemen, this is the citizen of Nigeria. This is the you can fight for your life. And so that is what God placed the ministers to do. And by the grace of God, that is what we are doing. The above of that, we also have the constitution. We are also calling the judgment. God has judgment. And that is written in the Bible. The constitution. God expects of you. God expects of someone. God expects of you. I want you to behave to your brother. I want you to talk to your sister. What is an acceptable behavior by God? Why you must behave? That's why you must act. What is your time and why you talk to someone? So that is in the kingdom, and we call it the judgment. Or the constitution. Then there is the law. Constitution is different from, judgment is different from the law. The law are things that does not change. The laws are things that are established by God. For instance, in the physical, there is the law of gravity. In the physical, there's a lot of sowing and reaping. When you plant maize, no matter how you pray, you can never harvest cocoa. No matter how much you work, if you plant coconut, you can never harvest, for instance, Ordinances are things you will do when you break a law. For instance, when you sin, there is an ordinance that provides a way of escape from the penalty of that sin. When you do what God does not expect you to do, there is an ordinance that is in the kingdom that gives you a way of escape. Praise the Lord. Then in the kingdom there is abundance. Then there is prosperity. Then there are opportunities. If you see the kingdom in the light of what I have said, what is your position? I want you to have an understanding of that position that you should take. Praise the Lord. Number one. It is very, very essential that you be yourself. Because it's a very, very big kingdom. And the king of that kingdom has created you for his own pleasure. When he created you, he did not consult with anybody. He created you in the life of pleasure. He created you in the right
stature.
If he created you big,
purple,
he needed the purple inside you.
That
is what gives you pleasure. When he sees the splendor in you, he is delighted because that is what he made. He made you so that when he looks at you, he can have that pleasure.
That
is why in the book of Colossians chapter 1, he said, thou hast created all things.
And
for thy pleasure, and they
are created
for his pleasure. Therefore, be yourself. Never try to be like somebody. He created only you. Don't be be like somebody else.
Má ṣe jẹ́ òmíràn.
No corrupt for your weakness.
Má ṣe jẹ́ sí ìfẹ́ ìwọ nìkan kó bí
bàjẹ́. By changing to be like somebody else.
Nípa pé o fẹ́ ṣe ẹlòmíràn.
God be just doing Jesus' name.